Correct. We're in previously. New friend. And as far as objectives go, we had a waterfall to climb, infiltrate a pirate base. However, I will first make some attempt to retrieve our nerd. I'm cut off from using my gunners here. As they are both notorious criminals. Oh, hello there. It occurs to me that maybe I should be trying to do more of this during action segments. At this point, I've been settling more into regular movement and gunplay. Otis is capable of a fair degree of wiggling.
Thank you.
some of those I can't grab. Others I can. I've already been happy places. No further need of those. Also, I haven't found another hubris coin yet. Close enough. And bringing back mechanics from the attack on Dreadnought. With me here. Close enough. Infiltration. Okay, that was purely an obstacle. There was nothing behind it. I was perhaps meant to evade it. be it noted, he has a gun. What is this further up? Just a preview. Don't mind me, I'm just gonna... Damn. I should check if there's a... in here. Corner. Switch. The dude. Although I shouldn't be able to bring an object in here. It's too narrow. Hold on. Before I do that, let me look at this man. May just be an alternate way to slip around there. so I'll just have to find switches to lower the alarm.
Okay.
Kind of hoping we'll retrieve Alphonse soon. It's been some time. I like this. Room set up to illustrate how they intend for you to deal with these things. Thank you. Pardon? What just happened? Alright, these must be handled with care. Thank you. puzzle. Jericho always has more knives. Alright, so off the first attempt. Seems the idea is just to use the web dash as a combination dodge and attack move. Just take advantage of you have iframes on the web dash to just kind of freak out and go everywhere, and that will keep you safe. Resistant to gun. There's something that's kind of felt sideways about the whole progression throughout this, that it's like, okay, there's three ancient owl MacGuffins, and we didn't get to touch any of them, or acquire capabilities from them. Each just kind of wound up in the hands of the enemy, essentially off camera. Now they present us with the idea of, well, okay, they're all over here in the box, so let's just go punch the man without either party having the benefit of any of the gizmos. It's weird. Look at that good cube map back there. That is a fine navigational instrument. And he has different hammers. Well, anchor. Different anchors for different occasions. I thought like two of them are more hammer than anchor. And that bone throne. That nerd! Otis is standing on the stove. The stove that you can see that it's like set up to. Or no, I suppose the idea is that it's just sharing an exhaust with the fireplace and has its own. Maybe it's just not lit. Still, being tied directly to the lit fireplace means it would be less than cold. Metal tube leading over to fire? Yeah, that would conduct. Otis, get off the stove. Thank you. Do you have coins? So, what do you think of my pirate friend? Look, sir. Sensei, I made a friend. Look at my friend. I found him. Alright, we have everything short of perfection. Perfection involves things like 100%ing the canon game, which... No. Thank you. Owls are not meant to space. Dracula stairs. They're giving us Dracula stairs. See, if I can't fly, then I also can't wield any of my gunners right now. Let's work on this parallax. The bits line up just right. I kind of liking that Solas is still Solas. Even though he is up here having seized the ultimate power, just gee, guys, I wasn't expecting it. What if I look, can you just not meaning to impose, but could you just like just wait there? I just gotta go summon the Dark Lord real quick. Big eclipse coming up, just I'll just be in the back. If you don't mind. Thank you. As hey player, if you don't mind, we'll just do a bunch of regular platforming in a game where you have otherwise gotten used to having full degrees of freedom motion. Outside of like one very early gimmick section. Books. Thank you. That's it's a lot of robots. That one was in the background. Alright, mechanics are back. Now that gravity is dead, everyone can fly.
Thank you.
Yeah, boss fight's off to a fine start. It's communicating itself pretty effectively and is a culmination of mechanics up to this point. Now, was punching him the false Dracula? Do we have a false and true Dracula situation? Is what he's about to tell us is that he's going to use the thing to, you know, put the world back together into, like, a planet instead of a series of, you know, disconnected bits that are gradually pushing away from each other. The owls broke gravity. They fucked it up. They had a regular orb planet, and they broke it. And it continued to gradually drift away from itself. And this is the machine to unbreak the planet. Maybe. Yes, hence things why, like, Captain Bolstrom has a map of a globe in addition to a map of a bunch of rocks floating in 3D space. That's the old world that used to exist before they broke it. And also, Maelstrom quite rightly has no reason to care if the planet becomes an uninhabitable cloud of rocks. Because he's a robot who cares only for fighting. Planet goes to space, he could go to space. And pirate in space. Pirates don't need farms. Taxes. Rude. That was Owls. felt kind of incomplete. Whole bunch of implied content that didn't happen. Unless it's like behind further collection percentages, like getting all the coins, and the cape, and finding the other hubris tokens, or... advising what other methods are necessary to face off against a true Dracula. Is like, really, no Maelstrom fight at any point? Of an extended anticlimax. It's okay. Dracula.